I'm Jared Dillian. Welcome to Be Smart, the podcast about money, the podcast about highbrow money, lowbrow money, and everything in between, and how not to be an idiot with your money, because there was a lot of that going around.
I live in the Myrtle Beach area. This is Horry County, South Carolina. Might be one of the cheapest places in the entire country. Very, very low cost of living. Extremely low cost of living. That's why people are moving here by the thousands. It's also a great place. You know, the weather here, love the weather here. You know, I like Miami a lot. Culturally, for me, that's kind of a better fit. But I like the weather here better. The summer sucks. Summer is too hot and lots of tourists and traffic, and it's annoying. I always want the summer to be over. The winter is really not that bad. It's, you know, 50s, maybe 40s sometime. You know, we get seasons here. But the spring and the fall are amazing. You're talking about, we basically get 5 or 6 months out of the year with 70 degree temperatures. It is amazing. And the humidity only shows up in the summer. So you're talking about 70 degree temperatures where it's not humid, and we get a lot of sunny days. I mean, the sun is shining here a lot. This is a great place. And a lot of people, they're like, the dirty Myrtle. You know, just do not have contempt prior to investigation. You know, I moved here basically sight unseen in 2010, and I have not regretted it. It's a great place. But we have cheap housing, cheap wages, cheap gas, cheap everything. We have a low cost of living. It's very easy to move here, very easy to retire here. This is the number two retirement destination in the country, and it is because of the low cost of living and the low property taxes. Shh, don't tell anyone. We have super low property taxes. So people move here from New York. They sell their house for like $900,000. They bought it for $70,000. They have all these gains, and they take the gains and they come down here and they buy a place for cash for like $300,000, and they just live off the rest, and that's retirement. Low cost of living is good, but it's a double-edged sword. It can also be bad. The wages here are atrocious. If you make $12 an hour in Horry County, South Carolina, it's actually not a bad deal. That's a decent amount of money down here. And I'm not kidding. I mean, you can get a decent place for $700 a month, and you can live pretty well. And you can have a pretty good quality of life. So this is not exactly a place with opportunities to make a lot of money. The primary industries here are restaurants and hospitality, so there are lots of low-wage jobs. Where are the high-wage jobs? The high-wage jobs are in places like New York. You know, we got it, New York City, you have lots of people making $500,000 a year, but they have a pretty low quality of life, and that money doesn't go very far. So how would you get started in New York if you were moving there? Well, if you were moving from Myrtle Beach to New York, you'd have to come up with first and last month's rent and moving expenses and other expenses, and you need about $20,000 just to get started, which means that there are high barriers to entry to moving to New York. There's no barriers to entry to moving here. In New York, there are high wages, but there are also high prices. Everything is expensive in New York. You know, I have a nephew who lives on the Upper East Side, and he's very young, and, you know, he's got to get food, and he says the grocery stores are the biggest ripoff in the world. He refuses to go to the grocery stores. $12 for a box of cereal. That's the one thing that stuck out at me. $12 for a box of cereal. You go out to dinner. A cheap dinner is $125. I can go out to dinner here for $40. It's insane how cheap it is here, and it is amazing. Now, the high prices are also a function of rules and regulations. There's a cost of compliance for all these rules and regulations, and the fewer laws and regulations, the cheaper things are. You know, we talk about this concept of inflation by fiat. You know, anytime you pass a law, anytime you create a regulation, there is a cost of compliance. And that cost is passed along to the consumer in the form of higher prices. See, businesses really don't absorb that cost. They just pass it along to you. So anytime a law is passed anywhere, the costs of compliance go up. Now, it's hard to save money in New York City. If you're making $400,000 a year, taxes take more than half. You spend the rest on rent and food and stuff, and then you got kids going to college. It's very hard to save. Now, generally, you live in a city because you like it, because there are a lot of things to do, not because you are going to save money. So, the best thing to do, is to find a high-wage job in a low-cost-of-living area. That is the best-case scenario. That's what I'm doing, okay? I actually wrote about this about 5 years ago. I called it the arbitrage, okay? So I can work from anywhere in the country. I can work in Alaska. I can work in Hawaii. I can work in Wyoming. It doesn't matter. As long as I have an internet connection, I can work anywhere in the country. So I choose to live here where the cost of living is very, very low, and it is amazing. It is amazing, and I am doing the arbitrage. So I have my own business, which is high-paying in a low-cost-of-living area. So that is the best scenario of all. So you're living somewhere right now, and you're deciding where you want to move in the country. The cost of living plays a big role. Maybe you want to move to Nashville. There's lots of things happening there. The real estate is already expensive. It's come up a lot. But there are no state income taxes. Let's say you want to move to San Francisco. I think you can forget about that. Although rents have come down a little bit in the last year. New York is a disaster. Chicago is a great city. The real estate is cheap, the weather is terrible, and the taxes are high. But you get the picture. There are places you go in the country that are going to be prohibitively expensive. In San Francisco, if you make less than $115,000 a year, you are below the poverty line. Having said all that, if you are frugal, you can make it work.